I did find some details on the new update that I wanted to talk about a little bit more in detail. One of the features that I really loved to see in the list, but I thought it would just be automatic, is not automatic. And so I wanted to cover this in a quick video just to make sure that everybody was aware how to do it. And what that is the autofocus on target switching in the plan mode and the close the arm upon completion of a plan. Now, those are two features listed in the app update, but I thought they would be fairly automatic, but apparently we have to go in and turn those on and tell it to do it. So to do that, I'm connected to my Seestar S30, and then I'm just going to click on the plan mode. And here you see I've set up a couple plans here. This one here is the 30.0.0, and I set that up as a plan just to test out how to make that autofocus work on the target switch, because I think that is a fabulous advantage of using the plan and having this new update to do that autofocus on the plan. And so I set up a plan just so that I could see how it worked and if there was something I needed to do. And initially I didn't see. So when I click on it to add the plan, the very first time I did, it came up with a little notification. I can't get it to duplicate it now because it was just a tutorial. It came up and it just had an arrow pointing to the add button there in the middle of the bottom portion of the screen where it says add, and just said to add to the plan. You needed to add objects. And then once I click that off, I can't duplicate it. It's not coming up with that anymore, but it was really non-information if you've used the plan before, because that's how you do it, is you just click this add button right here and it's not focused currently on something. So I wanted to just go in and I was just going to add an object just so that I could add it to the plan to see if it gave me the option of turning on or off that autofocus, or is it going to do it automatically? I wasn't really sure. Well, it doesn't really tell me anything here. So I did a little bit of looking around, and let's go ahead and we'll just add that to the plan just for the sake of adding it to the plan. And then when I come back to this main screen where it shows all of my plans, here's the one I just created. Up at the very top of the screen, there's an information button and a little settings icon. And you have to click on that. And that's where it comes up with those autofocus on target switch. And I think I'm just going to turn that on, and I haven't tried, but I'm assuming if I've turned it on, it will stay in that setting mode to be automatically turned on. And then closing the arm upon completion, I'm going to turn that on as well, so that when a plan executes and finishes, then it will close the arm, because I don't want that lens exposed to whatever it could be exposed to any more time than I'm imaging. And so I personally want it to close the arm after a plan is done. So I had to go in and set those settings up there. And I've not done that before on the plan. So I wanted to talk about that a little bit, because it's not an automatic thing that's going to just turn on and now you execute a plan and it's going to autofocus each target every time it switches to a new target. You have to go into that little settings icon there at the top and turn on that autofocus on target switch. And if you want it to close the arm once the plan is completed, you need to also have that turned on. It was defaulted to turn on, but the autofocus was not defaulted on. So I wanted to show those things on this feature in the new update, just so that you don't think that yours isn't working. If you're going to execute a plan, a lot of times you're not watching the screen. You go to bed and you execute the plan. Well, you wouldn't necessarily know if it had auto-focused. Unless, of course, you wake up and it's terribly out of focus, you will know it didn't either didn't do a good job or it didn't do an autofocus. But, you know, that doesn't happen that often that it's that far off. So you probably just wouldn't even notice that it hadn't happened. But I want it to do an autofocus on each target just because as the telescope moves around, as it gets cold, as it heats up, depending on the time of year, that autofocus can get off just a little bit. So I want it to do that autofocus every time it slews to a new target. So I wanted to talk about that today and show you how to turn that on. So I'll just do a brief recap, go back to the home screen so that we can start again. Click on the plan down there in the bottom right-hand corner side, and it opens the plan. And then up along the top, there's that little settings gear icon. You click on that, and that's where you turn those default, those functions on or off. And then you can click that little X to close that settings box, and then create your plan like you normally do. It doesn't matter if you do that, turn those on before or after you create your plan. It's just a matter of whether it's going to be used or not. And so I wanted to cover that here and make sure everybody was aware of how to do that. So another thing I wanted to talk about was our little helper friend that was added in an update a while ago and then it disappeared. Well, our little helper friend has returned. And in order to see it, when you go into stargazing and you click on, say, Andromeda, and then you click go gazing, it's giving me this error because it's indoors and not going to find it. But I'm just going to tell it to skip the polar aligning, and it's going to do some little tips there. But there's no sign of a helper friend that is that cute little ZWO star. And so we're unable to get those tips and information that that little tutor friend is helping us with. So I'm going to show you how to turn that on. So back here on the home screen, just click on the picture of the Seestar. In the top right-hand corner, click on that little gear icon to go into some settings. And then you scroll down to where it says Show Seestar Assistant, and you turn that on. And then when you come back out to that home screen, go to your stargazing, click on M31. And now when I click go gazing, and I'll skip the polar aligning again, of course, and then it's going to show our little tutorial friend.
The Andromeda Galaxy IPA. Andromeda, also known as Messier 31 M31, or NGC 224, and originally the Andromeda.
Okay, and so that's what it looks like. Now I'm going to show you, I should have done it while I was still on the screen, but let me get back there and I'll show you how to turn it off.
The Andromeda Galaxy IPA.
So you see
Andromeda,
little text
also known as Messier 31M31,
or NGC 224, right above him,
and originally the Andromeda Nebula, is a barred spiral galaxy with diameter.
Power that, and it turns off the volume of him. It doesn't turn him off because he's still on the screen, but it just turns off his speech. Now, I can't turn it back on unless I leave and go out and then come back in. But that's how you can turn it off if you don't want to hear it at the moment. But now we've got our little tutor friend on the screen. And so then if we decide, okay, we've seen M31, we've heard the tutor speech a million times, don't want to hear it anymore, we can go and turn him off by just repeating that process by clicking on the picture of the Seestar in the top right-hand corner, click on that gear icon, and then toggle that Show Seestar Assistant off. And then when you go back in, the next time that you're imaging and you go gazing, it's going to come up and he's going to be turned off. So I'm glad that they did listen to us about that, that we didn't really want to have him on the screen all the time. So they did give us a method of turning him off. I've only listened to it a few times. Just because we have cloudy weather. I think a lot of people are in the same boat, but I haven't had a chance to get outside with it. I had about an hour window yesterday that I was able to take it outside, but then it got windy and cloudy, and so I haven't been able to try it a whole lot, but that's how you turn that little assistant on and off. And so I thought that was very valuable information to know, because it's so easy to just see that come up on the screen and then you feel a little panicky because you don't really want it there all the time. It's kind of cute and novel in the beginning, but after the 500th time, I don't want to hear that every single time. There is some advantages to having it turned on, because it would be nice to just take up some of the time, because it takes a few moments for it to slew to the new object and locate it and do the initialization and start enhancing. And so listening to some educational things is great, you know, but after the second, third, fourth, hundredth time, it's maybe not something I want to hear every time. So I'm very glad that they were listening to some of the feedback and decided not to make that permanently on there, and were able to turn that little helper on and off. And so that's how you do that. So another thing we could talk about on this screen is the live capture versus the continuous capture. And that when you're imaging in the live view, that's where you can change this. Once you start imaging, I believe you have to stop the imaging to change this setting, but I haven't actually started imaging because it's indoors and I have not got anything centered. But just click the stop button if you're currently imaging, and then just toggle this over to continuous capture. And then to the left of that, it appears little boxes with, it has 50 in there. You can change it from one exposure to 999. And so if you want it to capture a certain number, so say, for example, you want it to do 100 of the exposures and then stop imaging, you can do that here. And just depends what how many you want to do. If you don't want it to continuously just continue all night long until you get up and stop it, or until a plan stops it, you want to tell it you want it to capture so many, then it's counting the actual saved exposures, not just the time that you're imaging. It's imaging until it gathers X number of exposures. And that's how you do that, is down here in the bottom. And that's on that live capture screen. And if you slew to M31 and it starts imaging, I believe you do have to click stop in order to change that, but that's where you do that. So that's another detail of the update that just recently came out. Another quick thing I wanted to talk about is under the DBE. Let me go gazing again. And when you are clicking on, let me get it to the live view. When you click on those little three lines right here, it gives you that DBE option. I was wondering what that stood for. There was a lot of speculation in the comments about it, but that does stand for dynamic background extraction. And my plan, once the weather clears up, is I want to do some experiments and try it with that turned on and using it and trying it without, so that we can see. My understanding is that that affects the live view only, just like the 4K live view imaging and how that works. And so that DBE is dynamic background extraction. From my understanding, it affects your live view. It does not affect the saved FIT files, individual exposures. And that's my understanding. It's possible that I'm wrong. I hope somebody clarifies if I am, but that's my understanding. But it does stand for dynamic background extraction. And once the skies clear up and I'm able to do some imaging, I'll do some experiments so that we can see the difference by using it and not using it. And so that's a plan for a future video. Anyway, I hope these few little deep dives into some of these features has been helpful. We'd love to have you on the journey, so feel free to subscribe. Just click on the College Gateway icon in the bottom of the video, and we would love to have you along. And as always, we're wishing everybody else clear skies, and somebody needs to wish that I had clear skies for me, and I'd appreciate that. Anyway, thanks for watching.